Assassin's Creed Liberation HD is an odd release in the franchise. Ported from a mobile platform to a PC, it introduced various problems, such as the inability to play the game on integrated Intel graphics chipsets and specific AMD graphics card models. Also, the game doesn't even start anymore without going through an abundance of fixes. Ubisoft support states that PC hardware that sees this dark look occur, making it hard to play, is due to the hardware being under the minimum system requirements. However, this exact model of Intel graphics chipset runs the Assassin's Creed 3 Liberation Remastered version, which is more demanding, just fine, and the colors are correct. Even with the color correction applied, it is hard to justify playing like this. When we compare Assassin's Creed Liberation HD with Assassin's Creed 3 Liberation Remastered, it resolves this problem, but runs slower than the HD release. At least the colors are correct. Note that this color issue doesn't affect newer AMD or Nvidia graphics cards, but at the time of making this video, Intel UHD 630 was the lowest of the lowest end of PC hardware I had access to. Since this video is about maximizing the performance in Assassin's Creed Liberation HD, at least we can compare the performance improvement this way, as the game is locked to around 60 FPS. Making comparisons on higher-end hardware tricky, as we wouldn't be able to see the difference due to the FPS lock. So if your goal is to maximize the FPS numbers in Assassin's Creed Liberation HD on a PC unaffected by this issue, I will guide you through an easy method to maximize your frame rates. The only reason I used the color-corrected gameplay is because I didn't have access to any lower-end hardware to test the game on due to its 60 FPS lock. However, if you are satisfied with color-corrected gameplay, you can apply the color correction via the respectable graphics card control panel. What you see in this video is the best I could do in the Intel Graphics Command Center. Applying color correction tricks will introduce a comic book-like appearance, similar to the Walking Dead, the Telltale Definitive series. So much information to process. Basically, everyone should instead play the remastered version, but if the additional performance found in the HD release, or if you already own the original release and don't feel like spending more money for the same game, is the reason to stick to it instead, who am I to tell you otherwise? Instead of benchmarking the game to see how it performs on specific PC hardware, let's see what we can do to optimize the game for the maximum possible performance. Before we proceed with the optimization process, download and install LowSpecs Experience. The download link for LowSpecs Experience is available in the video description. LowSpecs Experience is a PC video game optimization solution that I developed that allows you to optimize your favorite PC games for maximum performance. So first of all, start the installation process for the LowSpecs Experience. Once the installation is complete, start it from the newly created desktop shortcut. Now select the optimization catalog, select the applicable digital platform, and then select Assassin's Creed Liberation HD from the drop-down menu. Once done, press the load the optimization package. LowSpecs Experience will automatically detect a supported game version on your system. Now press OK and the optimization control panel will load. Once the optimization control panel has loaded, select the desired optimization presets and the rendering resolution for the game. Feel free to experiment with the optimization presets and rendering resolution to see what works best for your system. And now, to apply the optimization, press the Execute Optimization button and then start your game. So, speaking of additional fixes, here's how to apply them. To apply the stutter and freezing fix, known as the single-threaded load issue, start the game, then open Task Manager and go to the Details section. This fix applies to several Assassin's Creed games, including Assassin's Creed 2, Assassin's Creed Brotherhood, Assassin's Creed Revelations, Assassin's Creed 3, Assassin's Creed Liberation HD, Assassin's Creed 3 Remastered, and Assassin's Creed 3 Liberation Remastered. So for Assassin's Creed Liberation HD, you will find AC3LHD_32. Once you found the respectable process name, right-click on it and choose Set Affinity. Now, deselect the CPU 0 from the list and press OK. You can try re-enabling the CPU 0 if your CPU has fewer cores, but I wouldn't recommend it as the issue may return. Now you can safely return to your game and continue playing. To set an FPS lock on your desired game, download and install MSI Afterburner, then start RTSS, which is included with the installation. Navigate to the frame rate limit option and specify your preferred frame rate. While low specs experience may suggest a specific value where applicable after applying the optimization for any Assassin's Creed game, I recommend setting it to 58 for all older Assassin's Creed games. This fix addresses frame time inconsistencies, minimizes stuttering, resolves physics anomalies, and resolves potential game-breaking bugs associated with an unlocked frame rate, among other things. To apply the startup crash fix for Assassin's Creed Liberation HD, go to the game installation directory and find the AC3LHD_32 executable. Right-click on it and select Properties. Now, under the Compatibility tab, set the compatibility mode with Windows 7 or 8, and under the Settings section, check these two options. The game should now start and hang on the black screen for quite a bit. Don't panic and allow it to boot properly. Also, if you are unsatisfied with what you see, you can easily remove the optimization effects. That will do it for this video. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like and subscribe. Until next time, happy gaming!